Hello everyone, today I am going to teach the application of heat transfer to solar system, say solar steel. So first we will see what is solar steel. Solar steel is used for purifying the water using the renewable energy. So when the sunlight falls on the surface of glass, here this is the glass and this is the insulator. So when the solar energy falls on the surface of the glass, first it will get reflected, then absorbed by the glass, and the remaining portion will be transmitted to the water surface. At the water surface, again first reflection will take place, then some part will be absorbed by the water, and remaining portion will come to the lower portion. Here the surface is blackened, this is called the basin liner. So almost all radiations will get absorbed here. So temperature of the basin liner will increase. So what will happen? This basin liner will transfer the heat to the water. So water will get heat directly from the sunlight as well as from the basin liner. So what temperature of water will rise. So due to rise in temperature, evaporation will occur. And after evaporation, some condensation will take place. Where condensation will take place at the colder surface is the glass. So here condensation will take place and then it will be collected in a tray. So this is the best form of water. So today I am going to discuss thermal modeling. How to do the thermal modeling for solar system. That is the application of heat transfer. So for thermal modeling, we have certain assumptions. Why do we go for the assumptions? To simplify the cases. So first assumption is that the system is in a steady state condition. The level of the water is constant. There is a vapor leakage proof. Heat capacity of glass and absorbing insulating materials are neglected. There is no acidification of water. These are certain assumptions. So we will see the thermal modeling. So first is the energy balance equation. Energy balance equation for inner surface of glass cover. So energy balance means energy in is equal to energy out. So at the inner surface of the glass cover, energy, let us say alpha z dash is the effective absorptivity. So alpha z dash into I into az. Az is the area of the glass. So this takes the direct heat gain from the solar system. Another heat gain will be from water to glass surface. So here conduction, radiation and evaporation will occur. So the H, Wg, let us say equivalent heat transfer coefficient. So this will into Tg, Tw minus Tgi into Az. This is equal to heat will be transferred from lower inner surface to outer surface through conduction. So Kg by Lg into Tg I minus Tgo into Az. This is the energy balance equation for inner surface of the glass cover. For outer surface of glass, we have Kg upon Lg Tgi minus Tgo into Az. This is equal to the heat gain. Heat loss will be H1g into Az into Tgo minus Ta. H1g is the equivalent heat transfer from equivalent to conduction and radiation from glass surface to the atmosphere. Another will be for basin liner. For basin liner, alpha b dash is effective absorptivity I into Ab. This is the heat gain and it will be lost to the water. So H Bw Tw Tb minus Tw into Ab plus HBa Tb minus Ta into Ab. HBa is the equivalent heat transfer from basin liner to ambient, and HBa is the heat transfer from basin to water. The last equation, that is for water mass. So for water mass, you can see energy absorbed alpha W dash I into AB
This is the energy absorbed by direct solar intensity, and then from the basin liner SBW AB TB minus TW, and heat loss from our water surface to the inner surface of the glass. So this is HBW TB minus TW into AB. So this is a net gain. This will be equal to MW CW DTW upon DT. So using these four equations, we can find the expression for TW in terms of some good values like I, alpha, and D. And then we can find amount of water, that is HTWG into TW minus TGI upon L. L is the latent heat of water. Once we have calculated the amount of water coming, distilled water coming from the system, we can go for the further analysis. Thank you.